What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to add mods to your 7 Days to Die server. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. Surviving in 7 Days to Die can be a thrilling adventure on its own. But some players may want to add custom features for more exciting or challenging experiences. These extra features are called mods, and while they're not officially supported by Steam or by the game developers, that doesn't mean they're not usable. It just means they're a bit harder to download than other games might be. The good news is that is exactly what I'm going to be walking you through today, so you'll be able to add mods to your game in no time. Let's get started. Head towards the 7 Days to Die Nexus website and find a mod that you want to use. Once you've found that, open its page and then press Manual to open the downloading area. Select a download option, which for most people will be slow download. If your mod has multiple main files, it will allow you to choose the exact type to download. Press Manual Download on the one that you want and then finish normally. Wait for those files to download and then move them somewhere easy to get to, like a separate folder or your desktop. Now, before we actually install these onto the server, you'll need to install them on Steam. Open Steam and head towards the library, and then search for 7 Days to Die in your game list and then right-click on it. Hover over Manage and then press on Browse Local Files, and then create a new folder called Mods in that folder that opened. Open the Mods folder and drag that file that you downloaded into here, and then extract the contents using something like 7-Zip or another application. Don't delete any of the zipped mod files because we'll need them again in a minute. You will also want to check that the mod folder has XML files. These are going to be required for the mod to work. Now that your mods are installed in the game, it's time to upload them onto your server. While this can usually be done in the panel, some of these files are too large to upload here, so you're going to need to use an external FTP program. Download your preferred program, like FileZilla, and then run it. Head to your Apex server panel and near the top left, click FTP file access. And in this area, you can copy the FTP address, port, and username. Return to your external FTP and then enter the copied information into each field. Once the program is connected, you can enter your 7 Days to Die server profile, and then right-click anywhere in the server files and press Create Directory, and then name it Mods. Keep in mind that if you're using something other than FileZilla, this process might look a little different. Next, find the zipped mod files on your computer and drag them into the new mods directory. Wait for everything to finish uploading and then head back to your server panel's FTP file access. Log in with your password and then enter into the mods folder and checkmark all of the zipped files and then press unzip in the top right corner and click submit. Once that finishes, you can head to the top to click on your username, sending you back to the main panel where you can restart your server. In some cases, the Easy Anti-Cheat, or EAC, needs to be disabled for a mod to fully work. To do this, head to Config Files from the server panel and then click on the main 7 Days to Die configuration. Inside of this area, find the EAC enabled setting and change it to false. Make sure to press save at the top, and then you can restart the server to apply the changes. As for the game, select the launcher option when running it through Steam, and then uncheck the EAC option. If you are having trouble uploading, first make sure all of the mod files get uploaded into the mods folder for both the client and the server. Remember that you will have to first create this folder to upload the mods. As for the actual files, these files will be zipped and they will require an external program to extract them. Without extracting them, they will not work in game or on the server, even if they are correctly uploaded. If your mods aren't working, sometimes you need EAC disabled for them to run. This is required for the client and the server. Other times, mods won't function if they're outdated or broken. For example, you can't use A19 modifications on A20 versions of 7 Days to Die. Make sure to download and install versions that match your configuration, which should be the latest version since that's what our servers use. Using mods on 7 Days to Die is a great way to add custom features that you can't get with the regular game. Along with this, it's also a great way to make your server stand out against others, and it gives your players something different to look forward to that they might not get in other games. That's all for this one, gamers. As always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.